Welcome to CARTO Workflows. This is a visual, low-code analytical tool for streamlining your analysis. In this video, we'll be sharing how you can use workflows to easily analyze telco coverage. We'll start by creating a new workflow using the connection to our Snowflake data warehouse, and then adding our global LTE cell tower locations and the boundary of our study area, which in this case is Orange County, Florida. Our first step is to use a spatial filter to select the towers inside Orange County, filtering our dataset from 14 million to 25,000. During each stage of the process, our workflow native SQL queries are pushed to the Snowflake data cloud, meaning your analysis and queries never leave your data warehouse. At each stage of the workflow, you can view the SQL code which is driving the analysis and see the results of that section of the workflow, either in a data table or on a map. Now we know where our cell towers are, we can start to assess their coverage. First, we'll use STBuffer, which creates a fixed distance ring around each tower. We'll create a 500-meter buffer, which you can see the results of here. With our coverage established, we now need to know the population who benefit from this. To do this, we'll use a CARTO dataset called Spatial Features, which contains demographic information aggregated to a hexagonal grid called H3. So, our next step is to establish which H3 cells fall inside our coverage extent. We'll use a component called H3 Polyfill to do this, which fills a given area with H3 cells. We'll then use the Select Distinct component to remove any duplicates caused by overlapping buffers. Finally, we'll add our spatial features dataset for Florida to the workflow from our data warehouse and use a simple join by H3 ID to join the population to our coverage H3 layer. Now, we just need to save this as a table and take a look at the results. With our coverage layer now stored in our Snowflake data warehouse, we can now preview it in CARTO's Data Explorer, either on a map or in tabular format. From here, we can also quickly create an interactive map with the data. H3 is a spatial index, which is a type of spatial data designed to be small to store and quick to analyze. Another advantage of spatial indexes is that they're multi-resolution, which means they can render at different levels of detail depending on your zoom level. There are many visualization options available in CARTO Builder. You can change the base map, switch between 2D and 3D, and add a split screen for comparing data. For now, let's set the layer fill color to be dependent on population and select a color ramp. We can also choose a classification method or set something custom. Here, I'll set it to quantile to best represent the distribution of the data. We can also change the blending mode of the map, which makes it easier to see the base map detail underneath the layer. Another great feature in Builder is widgets. These are dynamic and graphic elements which help users interpret and interact with the data. In this instance, we'll add a range widget, which users can use to filter the data based on population. Thanks for watching this demo of CARTO Workflows. If you're interested in learning more about how you can use CARTO to bring advanced spatial capabilities to the Snowflake data cloud, head over to carto.com to pick up a free 2-week trial.